Good morning, everybody. I moved my table next to a window, so what you see now is all in natural daylight. I just wanted to show you how the top layer looks when it's finished. I had some trouble with the top layer, so I had to apply 3 more coats of resin before I was satisfied on how it dried. And I like to show you the side so you can see how thick the layer of resin actually became. Here's my finger. So from bottom to top it's 2.5 centimeters, and the layer of resin is about 0.5 centimeter, and I think it's actually about 7 or 8 layers of resin now. But what's nice is you can really see in between the layers what I did. I really like that, so I decided to put some gold leaf just on the MDF board, but not on the resin side, because I want this to show. I will give you a close-up now so you can see how the actual end result of the painting itself ended. Here you can see the small mica flakes that I used to create sand. It's really pretty and still really shiny. And here you can see some of the moonrock mica flakes that I created to make rocks underwater. And here you can see everything that I painted with the primary elements and the vivid polypore on top of the resin, and that is very pretty also. I'm giving you a close-up now. You can see it's very shiny. I'm trying to hold my camera as still as possible. And there you can see the mica moon rocks below the plant. Here you can actually see the glass air bubbles I made. And because I had to apply 3 more coats of resin, well, the bubbles actually, where's my, gone under the resin. I wanted it to stay on top of the resin a little bit, but well, that is not how it ended. I'm sorry. But I like it. You can still see the air bubbles pretty well, and I really like that effect. So of course I started this painting with applying resin art with alcohol. And that was the first layer. You can still see that. It's very shiny, very pretty. And it makes you think we are actually under the sea. And it's still, we have no artificial light now, so maybe you don't see it as much, but it's really still giving me nice sparkles. And there's the little fish. And I like you to see a close-up of the fish, because as you can see, about 0.5 centimeter below the rest of the fish, there you can see the moonrock mica flakes. And that's so pretty. It's giving me such an amazing depth. Okay, I'm trying to hold my camera still. I hope you can see. But yeah, I really like that. Yes, now you can see your help. And what I really like is that, you know, I painted the fins on top of the resin, but you still can see through that fins and see what's underneath. And I think that is very cool. I will show you. So Yeah, I'm very happy with the end result now. And I think it took me almost 6 weeks. But now I just need to apply my gold leaf and then I'm finished. This piece will be for sale. So if you are interested, please send me a message and let me know. Okay, I will put this camera in the tripod and I'll be back. Okay, what you see now is the back of the MDF. And I taped this, I don't know, about 6 weeks or maybe even 2 months ago. And so I'm going to see if I can remove this easily or I need to do a lot of, yeah, that's what I was afraid of. The resin really dried, of course. Oh, well, there it goes. Okay. But I learned that what I can do if this is not easily released, I could heat it up with how do you call that, honey? That hot air gun. Yeah, what we used to on the resin. The heat gun, sorry.
Yeah.
I can use the heat gun to heat this up a little bit and then remove the resin with no problem. I learned that from Doris, DF Designs, or from Joe Petty, I'm not sure anymore. But yeah, I can easily get it off. Oh, well, easily. It will be a little bit of work, but... And I'm sorry to see that actually a little bit of ink did come between the tape. But well, maybe I will paint the back. I will think about that. But okay, I just, yeah, there it goes. I just wanted to show you this, that I need to do this. And I'll be back with gluing the gold leaf to the sides. Okay, well, this took me about 15 minutes to get most of it off. Only here are a couple of drops of resin that are actually on the MDF board. And I tried to break them off, but I actually pulled off the paint. So what I'm going to do is I will sand this down and give the back a layer of paint. But, well, the tape does actually work pretty good and I'm surprised I could get it off after 2 months. Okay, what I will do now is I will put the painting on a Lazy Susan because we are going to glue gold leaf to the sides and I'm going to put the camera down in a minute so you can see actually what I am doing. First I like to show you I'm using just a normal craft glue. I know there is some special glue to put gold leaf on things, but I think this will work as good. And here I have a bunch of gold leaf. You see, it comes like this. I have never worked with gold leaf, so I hope it will work the way I want. Okay, I'll be back. Okay, I'm back. So I'm going to apply a very thin layer with a brush on here. And then I'm going to try to apply the gold leaf. And I have never done that, so Let's just hope it will work. I'm trying to apply a really thin layer of glue, because I think that's how people do that. And I'm going to show you a little piece how I do it. And then I will show you the end result, because this is probably going to be a lot of work. And that's way too long to show that all. But I wanted to see you how I do that. And then when I'm finished, I will show you. Well, okay. I think I covered a piece, and here you see I have the gold leaf. It's in between two layers of paper. Whoa, it's really, really thin. So what I will do is I will bend this paper a little bit like this, and then I will push it against the sides. And then try to pull it off a little. I'm not sure if this is how it's done, but it's on, but not everywhere. So I will just get another piece and push it on there again. So this is going to take me a lot of gold leaf, but well, that's just the way it is. And yeah, as you can see, you see it's already sticking to my finger. I think there's a little piece that's not covered, so I will try to get in a little bit of that glue and push this little piece in it. Oh my goodness, this is going to be a lot of work, guys. But that's okay. I want to take my time, because I want this all just to be perfect. And I will push a little bit against it again. This is so fragile. Okay, and when I think it will be, yeah, glued solid to the surface, then I will go over it with a brush. I think I can do that now, I hope, and brush off the excess gold leaf. No, you see, I'm just brushing it off, so I probably need to let the glue dry before I do that. So then I will brush it off later. I will just attach a little bit again. Oh my goodness, what was I thinking? It looks very pretty, but this is actually going to be a lot of work. And it is sticking a little bit to the resin, but well, I can scrape that off, I see. Okay, well, I will continue, and I will be back when I'm going over it with a clean brush. Okay. Hello. Well, I have done the whole painting, and what I'm doing now is with a brush, brushing the excessive gold leaf. Some of it got a little bit stuck. I don't know if you can see that on my resin, but I can remove that later on. You see, when I use my nail, just very careful, it will come off. So, well, what I'm going to do is apply a UV varnish over the gold leaf. But I won't be showing you that anymore, because for the video, I'm done. I hope you enjoyed this series. I intend to do another one some other time, but in the near future I will be doing some acrylic pouring and alcohol inks, etc. And maybe just normal resin paintings, but I'm sure I'm going to do a big project again. And I'd like to thank you for watching and bear with me for 7 parts. I know it was very long, but I really enjoyed it and I hope you did too. Okay, see you next time. Thank you for watching.